Hi, garden friends. I was talking about rose hips in that video I shared with you from my house. And so I wanted to show you what rose hips look like on the inside. Now, if you didn't see the other video or you're not sure what I'm talking about, rose hip is what the rose grows right down here after the flower has died. So here we've got a rose. And you can see all of the anther and filaments. I'm not entirely sure which one of these little protrusions is the sticky stigma, but you see all of those guys right in the center, right? And we know that this is the ovule down here where the pollen that gets trapped on the sticky stigma will travel down here and produce seeds. So, after the petals have all fallen off, this part right here swells up really big. Oh, my petals are falling off. Look at that. Depending on the rosebush, the sizes might vary, but this one's really big. This is from a rosebush I have in my yard that the rose is kind of that orange color. Sorry, I've got some background noise. But this is what a rose hip looks like. Inside. Now you remember the story we read about a fruit is a suitcase for seeds. So rose hips are sort of like the fruit of the rose plant. And these little guys, they're called achenes. And it's basically the seed for the rose. The seed is actually inside this hard shell. But this is what the rose hip looks like when you cut it open. So right here was where the all the filaments that produce the pollen, or the anther, I guess. So these are the filaments that connect to the anther and produce the pollen. You see how they go inside what becomes the rose hip. And if you look at this rose hip, you can see, if you recall, what those sort of, we called them false petals or the green petals. They're sort of in between a leaf and a petal, right? Those were the sepals, S-E-P-A-L, sepals. So I'm going to break those off because it's a little easier to cut. And let's cut this one up and see how many achenes it might have inside of it. Check that out. Okay. There we go. So I'm gonna pop these out. Actually, I think I'll use this little pokey thing. There's a one. There's another one. Come on out. That one's in there. There we go. Two. There's another one. Three. Come on. Here we go. I feel like that's two stuck together. Look at that. So there's four. And then I wonder if we have four on this side of it. Let's check it out. One. That one looks like maybe it's not totally developed. Two. I think there's one more in there. Here we go. Three. There's a fourth one. There we go. Look at all that. So if we were to plant these, we could grow our own rose bushes. Now they wouldn't be as big as just like any other plant. If you start it from seed, it's going to start out really small. But I think I'm going to try an experiment, and I'm going to plant these and see what they will do and how quickly they will grow. So I will update you on their growth. So again, this is what the rose hip looked like before we cut it open. And then when we cut it open, you can see the meaty part. This is the shell, and it has, let me look at the, it's called the hypanthium. Hypanthium, that is the fleshy cell, that shell, that was hard to say, fleshy shell that holds the seeds. So we have, let's go over our anatomy again. This is the sepal. These are the remains of the anthers and the filaments right here. Can you see? Let's see if I get close. You can kind of see how they look like little strings, right? Oop, there we go. And then this is called the hypanthium, the shell which contains our seeds. And then again, the seeds are actually called an achene because it's not really the seed. The seed is inside this tiny shell. Let's see if I can zoom in there. I don't know if picking it up makes it better or if zooming with my camera will make a better picture. How's that? I feel like that's a little blurry. But check those out. I will update you and let you know if I can grow some roses. I found a really cool illustration. Let me see if I can move this and share this with you. So this is from a website of an artist, lizzieharper.co.uk is her website. And she's a botanical illustrator. And she has these really awesome anatomy of a rosehip pictures. Look at that. That's such a cool diagram. She's a really fantastic artist. I bet if you folks need an art project, your teachers would love to see your drawings of roses and rose hips, and they could probably share them with me if you wanted to do that. That'd be awesome. So that's what the inside of a rose hip looks like. Thanks for listening, and I will keep you updated on how these achenes do once I get them planted. Bye-bye.